What's good? It's your boy Binks, and y'all are the family, and together we are the Binks family. Welcome back to another Mother Freaka video. All right, man, look, so today we're going to be talking about a little juicy topic that I actually kind of want to get a little bit personal on and that I'm actually really passionate about. Now, if you guys are ready for this video, go down below and press the like button. If you guys don't, I don't care. It's just a suggestion. But nevertheless, I'm glad you guys came here and joined me for today's topic. You guys want to know how to grow on YouTube. Now, listen, I ain't no veteran. I haven't been on YouTube for like 10 years, but I have learned a lot in the 3 years I have been making videos. So I feel a lot of the information I'm gonna give you guys is gonna be valid, so make sure you guys stay tuned and listen to everything I gotta say. Now, I know a lot of you guys are YouTubers yourself, so I'm hoping this video helps you out. And for the people that wanna start YouTube, I'm hoping this helps you out as well. Now listen, first things first, if you wanna start on YouTube, you're gonna have to have a decent name, right? Like, you don't wanna have no weird name like Cat Monster 94, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's just not catchy enough that people actually want to repeat that to their friends. Like, hey, have you watched Cat Monster 94's video? That's just not gonna be it. If you want to grow on YouTube, you're gonna have to have a decent name. Now, that may be obvious, but some people don't know that. Now listen, after you guys get y'all YouTube names, y'all basically want to start making y'all channel look presentable. Now, when I say that, make sure your profile picture is something that people want to look at. Don't put like a picture of an eggplant. Like, who wants to really like join somebody that has an eggplant as their profile picture? Nobody wants to sit here and click on a glizzy all day. Either take your time to make your own profile picture or find something really dope off the internet and use that as your profile picture, because that's what people are gonna remember you by. Also, make sure you guys have some type of banner on your channel. If you have like a certain color theme that your channel kind of revolves around, like the color orange, maybe you might want to put like an orange looking sunset, you know what I'm saying? It's really important to make sure that people take your channel seriously. And you're not just making some just goofball channel that nobody's gonna ever remember. It gotta look like you're caring about your own channel, or nobody else is gonna care about it. Now, after your channel looks good, you got the motherfucking banner, you got the nice logo, you got a cool name that's catchy, now you gotta start worrying about the content that you're gonna put on your channel, because that matters. Now, when you're trying to grow as a YouTuber, people need to know you for something, right? Now, some of y'all don't wanna get put in a category with being like a certain YouTuber. You can look at PewDiePie or T-Series or something. They got 100+ million subscribers, meaning there's 100 million people with a channel. I'd probably say like maybe 20 million of those people actually post videos. Now, that's a lot of competition. Now check this out, 70% of those people are probably not really in competition with you, because if you make certain content like how I make dreadlock videos, there's only probably a couple thousand dreadlock channels. Now, I'm not saying that you guys can only do one thing, because as you guys know, I posted a lot of different type of content in my past. People know me as like the dreadlock YouTuber, or I also do hip-hop reaction videos. People know me as the hip-hop reaction video dude. It's harder for people to come back and know what they're expecting if you do a whole lot of random crap. Now that that's out the way, you guys actually gotta film a video now. Now, a lot of y'all might be thinking, well, I could film a video, but I don't got the best equipment. Now listen, I grew the first 1,000 of the Binks family just using an Android camera. It doesn't really always matter the full quality you have when you're first starting. People know that you're starting. They know that you ain't coming in there with this like a 4K video and like crazy edits. People know that. They don't expect that. They're gonna maybe expect that when you start getting higher up, but they know you're just starting. They're not expecting a lot. But eventually you are gonna have to upgrade. I didn't buy my first actual camera until like a year and a half on YouTube. Now you gotta make sure that your video brands you as well. When people look at your video, they kinda wanna see things that are familiar, and that's you. Keep the same background if you guys do sit down videos. Have a similar background most of the time, especially if you guys take thumbnails. You guys kind of want to have a consistent background. Now, when you're trying to grow, it's really important to take as many advantages as you can for people to recognize you. Now, when you're making a video, it's important for people to mess with you for you. Don't try to be somebody else in your videos when you start recording. If you guys watch like a Mr. Beast video, don't try to be Mr. Beast 2.0, because they will just go watch Mr. Beast if they want that. Make sure you're yourself, so you don't always got to put on a fake persona, because that's going to really make your channel not feel so much fun anymore. Is that even a word? I don't even know. Now, if it takes you a long time to find that personality that you aren't, then it's gonna take you a long time to actually record a video again. Just act like yourself, it's easier, get more videos done, and you start growing. That was good. Now, when you're recording your video, always think about an epic thumbnail. Your thumbnail is pretty much the first thing that catches people's attention. If you guys have a trash thumbnail, nobody's clicking on the video. Now, when y'all recording, make sure you guys stop, take a few seconds to take like a crazy thumbnail, like, you know what I'm saying? Do one of them. Nobody's gonna see your channel or your personality if you guys don't got a good thumbnail. People have to click on it. And once you get a good thumbnail, y'all gotta make sure that y'all actually edit y'all thumbnails, bro. Don't just take a screenshot and make that your thumbnail. That's not usually gonna work if you're trying to grow. Go download yourself a picture editing app or something and learn how to edit. Make sure that your thumbnails look noticeable. It looks like you. I can tell you right now, this person right here on the screen, if you guys don't know her, it's SSS Sniper Wolf. Almost every single one of her thumbnails look the same. They see your face, they gonna click it. As well as this person, Mr. Beast. Talked about him earlier in the video. Most of his thumbnails look the same and they all get clicked on. But the two people I just showed you, we only click on their videos because we know their personality. So when it comes to being seen, it's really important that you guys have a good video. Plus, make sure that you guys have a lit thumbnail because people are going to click on you. Make sure y'all thumbnails are popping. I'd say about 15 to 20 minutes on each thumbnail at least. But honestly, somebody scrolls probably by like 200 thumbnails in a day of watching YouTube. And you want your thumbnail to be seen. So it really is important for you to have a good thumbnail because that's the first thing someone is going to see. That goes hand in hand with having a good title. Those are the two things that you guys got. Is a thumbnail and a title, bro. Make sure you guys have a good title. Like maybe ask a question in your title or give somebody like a dilemma in your title or make someone build like curiosity or something. Like titles are really important. And make sure you guys don't clickbait too much because I promise you ain't nobody gonna come back to your channel and you're not gonna grow if you be clickbaiting. Say if you're recording a video and you've seen like a dollar on the floor, don't make a title talking about I found $100. That's not cool. Nobody's gonna wanna watch you after you just lied to them. That doesn't mean you can't pizzazz the title up a little bit and be like, I found money on the floor. It brings up the curiosity of like, how much money did that person find? Let me see how they found the money. Don't lie to people if you're trying to grow your channel, bro. That's just not how it works, bro. Be 100. Last but not least, I'm gonna talk about tags on a video. It's really important that you guys have decent tags on your videos. Kinda put almost word for word what your video is about in your tags. If I make a dreadlock video, I'm gonna put dreadlocks. Also, then I'm gonna put another tag that says dreads. Then I'm gonna put another tag that says locks. I would say the more tags, the better, but make sure they're all on topic because YouTube kind of tracks how many times you show someone your thumbnail. And if someone's skipping over your thumbnail, skipping over your video, it has a bad click rate and YouTube is not gonna show it to nobody. Now, if you guys are doing a gaming video about Call of Duty or Fortnite, don't put a tag winning lottery or something like that as a tag. Like, then your video might end up popping up on the side of someone winning the lottery as their video. And then someone's gonna skip right past your stuff because it doesn't relate at all to what they're kind of interested in. I don't know if that made sense, but I could do a bigger video if you guys want. I kind of freestyled this video, so that's all I could really think about right now on helping y'all grow y'all channel. The last thing I can say is to make sure you guys stay consistent. Post at like a decent time when people are actually awake. Don't be posting at like 12 o'clock at night. You're probably not gonna get no views. You're not gonna grow. Nobody's gonna see your video. Say if you guys are working a job or go to school and you only have the weekends off, take that time to record as many videos as possible on the weekends. Even if you can't edit them, take your time to record as much as you guys can on the weekends, and maybe during the weekdays you guys can edit videos and upload them. If you want to grow, it's really important to keep the people that you have already there by posting and to try to show your videos to new people. So you got to make sure you upload. Now honestly, I know somebody that been posting YouTube videos for years and he finally had his break a couple months ago, but his name is Devontae the One. He makes animated videos and shout out to him, bro, because he really been grinding. I've been seeing it from him from like a long time ago. He made great thumbnails, great videos. It just took a time for people to even check out what he had going on. So even if everything I just said doesn't work right away, it's gonna work eventually. I promise you guys to stay consistent, drop videos. Make sure you guys take your time with everything, craft your videos properly. But like I said, I pretty much freestyled this video, so I hope I helped you guys in some type of way, shape, or form. I couldn't make more detailed videos if you guys want. You guys can hit me up on my social media. That's all on the screen right here. If you have any questions or any other tips that you want me to give y'all. All right, bro, I'm done. Bigs family, I hope you have a good rest of your day, evening, or night, whenever you're watching this, and I'll catch you in the next video.